Take three. Good morning, everyone. There's Bruno. I'm Mike. There's part of Bruno's little toy stash for Christmas. And welcome back to our channel, Mike and Bruno's Garage. Today we will be working out in the garage. I do have the heater going right now. Get it warmed up and I'll show you what we'll be working on. Okay, everyone. Today's victim, or should I say, next project, is a John Deere trs21 snow thrower. The backstory behind this was my dad's. Told me to bring it home on Christmas when we went up to visit. Hope everybody had a good holiday. It's set, I know, for at least a year. He couldn't tell me when the last time it was running. It is a two-stroke Tecumseh. The paddles and, of course, the blade, the scraper blade, are kind of past it. So those will be need to be looked at, which will be fine. Has compression, has spark. Will start, but will not stay running on its own. It will stay running on the prime. However, it has sat for so long, and with it being a two-stroke, I imagine it's pretty gummy and oily. So that means I'll take the carburetor apart. With it being a Tecumseh, we do have a John Deere dealer here. However, I don't know if they have anything on hand in new old stock. There was a tag on it. And there's just a little bit. I don't think that's going to matter. That stated down here. Get you over here. Tecumseh products. This engine meets 95 and 98 California and US EPA applicable emissions. So 98 at the most, I bet you anything that this is going to be 25 years old. Does have a certified by independent laboratories, institute safety standard. I do have a serial number for it. Deere Company, Moline, Illinois, made in the USA. With that being said, as you can see, here's part of the butt of the blade, scraper blade. The nuts have been all ground down. However, that's going to be secondary due to the fact that I want to make sure that it will stay running on its own power. And with that being said, I believe I have to take the wheels off. And we can see about getting, this has been into before because the clips on the side here are not even attached to the plastic. So somebody's been in here before. Whether or not what they did, we will find out. I took off the top cover to inspect the spark plug. Two of the screws were missing, and one was actually a wood screw. So somebody's been in here before. I'm just not quite sure who. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get the wheels off and that back cover off. And see what we need to do to get that carburetor off. All right, be right back. Okay, doing this by hand with a screwdriver is not gonna be optimal. I'll have to run inside real quick and get my impact driver. I will be back shortly and be right back. Okay. All right. Hopefully she got a magnetic tray. Oh, hey, here we go. All right. I next, after the heater, my next investment hopefully will be on getting a hydraulic lift table. Because working at this level here is going to be entertainment value. So with that being said, yeah, when they put this back together, they didn't get the plastic in the chips. So that would be a little disconcerting. If I get this running, I might, my dad said go ahead and sell it. But there's a younger couple next door to us that only has like shovels, and they got some pretty low setting cars. Well, regular like Toyotas. One's a Hyundai, I think. And so every once in a while, we do get plowed in. All right, let's see if we get this cap off of here. Oh, okay, just a little E-clip on there. There, oh, almost. Let's see if I can, I got new ones. In my stash. Come on, there we go. There it is. Then there's a washer, nylon washer. Wheel comes off. Let's just set all that stuff right there and try not to kick it later, huh? Oh, there's a bushing that goes in there with a washer. Okay. So bushing, washer, wheel, washer, E-clip. All right. Okay. Let's go ahead and slide this off. Okay, this cover should come off. Okay, there's a clip here. Yeah, they didn't even bother putting all the clips back in. But yeah, this is an oily mess. Let's see, can we separate him this way? There we go. All right. Looks like it's been leaking. Does it look like there's any mouse nests or anything like that in there? But yeah, she's a real oily mess. Oh boy. Yeah, that'll need to be sprayed out. Okay. And there's something here that's laying here. What did that come off of? Doesn't look like. Well, that's interesting. Have no idea what that goes to. Just laying there in the bottom. Looks like some sort of ran over something, maybe. And we'll put him in a magnetic tray in case we run across something where it needs to be. Okay. So we got that there. It looks like. Okay, good thing I bought those. Get a little pair of pliers. Let me see. Let me double check. I think I might even have a extra fuel filter. I know they're just a screen, but if that's any indication. Chase them down later. Oh, there, yeah, I do. Here we are. Looks about the same thing, so we'll replace that. Yeah, depending on how dirty and hicky it looks. Let's clamp off that fuel line. I got these here. I also got some hemostats, but these are made out of plastic, and so yeah, let's go ahead and get that clip off of there first, maybe. Boy, that's a stubborn old monkey, isn't it? There we go. Put him on there like so. Okay. Fuel line pliers. Can't get that to break loose a little bit. There we go. Okay. Come on out there. Yeah, there's some junk in there. A little bit of fuel in there yet. But it's all part of the experience. She's being a stubborn little monkey. Come on. Come off of there. Very easy. There we go. Sort of. Well, let me fiddle with this here and I'll get you back. Okay, got that off of there. It looks like I need to remove the fuel line to get to... God, what a junky mess. Okay, well, let's try this. Come on, Well, they got this all turned around to where cooperate with me? No. There we go. Oh, you stubborn monkey. Yeah, so something tells me this has been on there for quite a while. Let me get a pick in there. See if a pick doesn't help. Just a minute, I hear Bruno barking. Mail must be here. Well, the gas line ripped on me. So, we'll add that to the parts list, I guess. Chances are I probably should replace all of it. Then once I get this off, then we can mate it up. There we go. Yeah. Now we'll put that in the... Yeah, Bruno's losing his mind with the mailman. Yeah, let's get the rest of this off of here, maybe. But like I said, with those green clamps on there, chances are those are the originals. So this is probably going to be a two-stage deal. Oh, you stubborn. Stubborn, stubborn, stubborn. Actually, let's worry about that once we get the carburetor off. Okay. Now, I knew that it would take a Allen key or hex key. However, this bolt here, where my middle finger is, you can get to, but the fuel inlet is right above the other one. So I picked up this package of Eklund ball hex on the bottom. Got a metric and a standard. Said industrial quality, but the best part of it, it said, let's see if it'll focus. Come on now. So, now why won't it show up? Made in the USA. So, I have a feeling it's going to be metric. I'm sure. I'll start off with that first. To get the carburetor off, drain the rest of that gas out of there, get it set aside. We will take it inside and work on it there. It looks like it might be a 6. Well, how does this? Oh, okay. There we go. Nope. Number five? Nope. Huh. Number four. Okay. All right. Kind of surprised at how much oil is here. Come on. How far I need to go? Oh, okay. Well, that little metering area. Okay. Well, you are a stubborn. Help if I could see. Let me adjust the. Well, that rubber does need to come off. Oh boy. Well, you stubborn mother. There we go. It could go in the garbage. Yeah, this is my first time tearing one of these apart. So, there's probably a few of you out there going, I know this would make it a lot easier. Yeah, probably. However, I'm all about the learning curve. Okay. Stubborn little monkey. Sorry, my hand's in the way. I got the primer line to disconnect. Probably the governor spring and the throttle arm. Boy, that just really does not. And it is very not conducive. Oh, I'm just trying not to drop. There we go. trying not to drop it down into the machine itself. Wow. How does that not come out of there right? Okay, there we go. All right. So there's me parts. All right. Can I flip that around? See about getting this line off for the primer without ruining it. Looks like I might have some play there. Boy, oh boy. This is going to be, come on. This has been like the most dope, and that broke too. Well, maybe. Ripping. Come on. Okay. Now we have, let's see. Come around the other side, folks. I'm making a right big mess of this, ain't I? Okay. So the spring and the carburetor. Let's see if I can get that to come off of there. There we go. All right. I'll leave that like so. Plate adapter. Looks like the gasket might be okay. Gasket came off okay. I think with all the oil and stuff on there that is on there. All righty. Well, there's the carburetor, gentlemen. There's no real set screws or anything like that. The intake, the choke. And it runs off a governor. Primer line. Looks like that's kind of the idle circuit there. So we'll get this apart. And see what we can come up with. Maybe we can get this all done in one take. You know, minus the gas line. Yeah, we'll see if there's enough left there. Maybe there's just enough to get some play in there. I mean, the plates seem to move okay. It's just the intake. I ain't gonna mess with him too much. Now let's get that needle and seat out of there and see about getting some cleaning. I'll be right back. Okay, guys. And back again. Try and wipe off some of this external junk a little bit before we start tearing into that stuff is just everywhere. I don't have an ultrasonic cleaner. Oh, hey, that spring there is what holds. Okay. Probably don't want to lose that. Looks like there's a little bit of corrosion on here too. But as long as we can get some of the major gunk off of it. Okay. Has a 30 on there with a 170, so the bowl nut is going to also be the jet. And then there's probably going to be an emulsion tube in there too. So, oh boy, that dog of mine, I tell you what, he gets pretty antsy. Hold on. Okay, just the mailman again. Sorry for this video getting kind of long in the tooth. However, there has been a few interruptions. Okay. That heater, by the way, works really great. Okay. Looks like we got a little port that we'll need to clean out too. So, let's see here. What's she gonna be? It's not going to be a 13. No, probably a 10. Nope. Wow. Okay. Some weird half inch. Okay, let's see if I can get that to come off of there. Okay, half inch. There we go. Okay. Yeah, she's pretty plugged up. Can I save the gasket? Oh, she's really plugged. Okay, come on. What is my luck going to be with this gasket? Zero to none. Okay. Yeah, let's see how small we need to go, huh, guys? Come on. I'll start with the smallest one first. Yeah, it feels kind of gooey. And she just does not want to go through there, does she? Okay. Why is it? Like I have. Sorry for knocking the camera, guys. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Okay. Now, can I get it to come out both ends? Well, she came out. Okay. Okay. Now that stuff isn't good on the gasket. So we're just going to try and dry that off as best we can. All right, it's part of my reach, guys, but I got you to the right of me, and so that, oh, come on, focus, you stubborn mule. It's all blown out, and I'm getting spray out of each one, so there's that. Okay, now, how bad is the bowl going to be? Oh, not too bad. Yeah. Can you see that, guys? Here, let me try and get you guys in a little closer here. Okay. Let's see here. There we go. As you can see, that. And there's a little bit of sediment down in the bowl there. But not too bad. There's no real corrosion or anything. So I think most of that we can just wipe and clean out. Okay. Spray this out real quick. There we go. Not too bad. I think we can live with that. Like I said, I don't know how long this has been sitting, but it probably sat long enough to where that jet got good and clogged up. So there's one bowl. Okay. Now let's check. Okay, see how that spring is set up in there? A second, let me get a dry rag here. Let that float kind of sit on itself a little bit. That spring is awfully tricky. Never seen that kind of a spring before, but doesn't mean they don't exist, because there I am looking at it. Now that spring is laying up against the float. Does that look like it's just the float level looks okay, I think. So let's see if we can get this out without see if I can get this gasket off of here. Come on, without ruining anything here. Okay, there we go. Hopefully that'll stay in shape. Doesn't feel too bad. Keep that out of the goo. All right. Now to remember how that spring goes in. Looks like it hooks into the side of the carb here. Okay. Starting to cool off in here, guys. I might have to turn the heater back on here before too long. Come on. There we go. Okay. You can keep that spring in there just like that. Okay. This goes up against the flat like so. Let's see if we can put the pin in there so we don't lose him again. Set him carefully down there. Wipe off the pin. All There we go. And it's kind of set in the goop. Yeah, this is taking a little bit. Oh, there we go. Sorry. Paying attention to what I'm doing and not keeping you guys in the shot. Put him in there. Now, a needle. Well, that looks practically brand new. So with it being a metal needle and it being a Tecumseh motor, I'm betting Bruno's lunch money that there's a rubber O-ring in there. So I'm just going to carefully spray that out. Fluid did come out the inlet tube, and it does look pretty decent in there. I'm not going to stick anything in there. I don't want to blow that out and lose it. I'm trying to keep from buying a carb kit or having to track one down, see if we can't just clean it up enough to where I can put it back into the machine. Let's see, the emulsion tube. Now this would be a little blue plastic deal. Yeah, I can see through it, but the pickup part of it, I don't know about. So let's see if I got a screwdriver we can use to push that down in there without ruining it. It doesn't look like it. Well, well, well. This long enough and narrow enough to kind of get in there without doing any damage to it? I don't know. Got this here. Looks like it's right in the center anyway, so let's see if I have any luck. It doesn't look like it. However, it's that screw. Well, can I spray that out and get by with it? Well, it's drawing up through there. I might have just gotten by doing that. All right. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put this back together and get it back on the machine and see where we're at. Okay, guys, after some fiddling, I got that spring to go back in correctly. I did the blow test. So that's telling me it's doing something in there adequately enough. I'll just put the bowl back on and see if we can't get it back on the machine. Oh boy, that was a good time. Yeah, not really. That was the kind of stubbornest thing I've ever had to deal with. All right, be right back. Okay. Let's just see where we're at here, folks. Okay. I have enough. Good, buddy. Is that double gasketing? An adapter plate. Now I need to. Oh, bugger. I can see why some guys edit their videos. That should be enough to be on the primer bowl. I tell you what, guys. Surprises, well, not really. I guess I should. Okay, let's see if there's a way to get that spring back on there. There's the spring. Get the spring in there. Okay, and now can I get the Z bend to go back in? Yes. Okay. Well, all right. Let's get the other bolt fit. Oh,
Okay. Yeah, making sure I got all my washers. Okay. Ow. Well, now you stubborn monkey, how did I? There we go. Okay. Looks like I had just enough. There we go. I think I got primer line in okay. Should have brought my little inspection line. Well, I got this one. Alrighty. Is he in there? Yeah, I could go in a little bit more. Whoopsie. Is that metal? That is. Okay. Is that enough metal? Probably not. Sake, you stubborn monkey. Why? What's going on here now? Wow, guys. Are you kidding me? There's just like not a whole lot of room in here, is there? Started. And he started. Okay. Going on here. Huh. there's something I'm missing here. Because it's like bottoming out. I got going on now. Huh. Well, it wants to go down in there halfway. Why is it? It's just being stubborn. Typical. Just being stubborn. Sorry if I'm in the way, guys, but why is that all of a sudden not wanting to go all the way through? No plate that I'm missing. I don't think that it's stripping. This just doesn't want to. Why is it not going down? What is going on here? Well, guys, I'm going to have to come back to you and see what the heck's going on here. Okay, guys, I got that carburetor back on. It was a stubborn little monkey. I'm gonna see if I got enough fuel line here to square off the corners. And get that back on. But yeah, it wasn't hooking up the primer line. It wasn't the governor linkage or anything. It was this bolt right here, just did not want to go a certain way. And I had to kind of loosen this one almost all the way out, kind of cock the carburetor a little bit to get it to sit. But it finally went in. So we got this here. I just kind of sprayed out the filter a little bit. It's just like a window screen inside there. So hopefully we can get this back on there. I know I'm kind of in the way, but yeah, this is going to be a stubborn mule. Over the almost. There we go. Okay. Now, what do we have? Oh, yeah, we got enough fuel line there. All right. I think we're making progress here, guys. For some reason, maybe that needs to be bent out a little bit more. Oh, did that get bent? There we go. But we'll get the fuel line back on there. Come on, you stubborn little monkey. Deal with a lot of stubborn monkeys. Yeah, those fuel lines will probably need to be replaced at some time. However, our goal is to get it to consistently run without spending any money. The only thing I spent the money on was the tool to get those off of there. And so maybe there we go. Throw a bed plate on it. And then see how she runs and see if she's worth the extra money to put into her. Okay, let's go ahead. I'll put the wheels on it so we can set her back down. Then I'll worry about putting that cover plate on there. I just want to kind of check and see if we're getting any leakage. So we got our bushing in, Okay. All right. Bushing, washer. Wheel, washer, give me that light so I can see the seat clamp. Now there is a little bit of fuel in there. We'll see if we can get this thing to get all rough and ready. Got a feeling she's gonna smoke like a double dog. But hopefully we will have her in good enough shape to run. All right. Oh, I'm leaking gas. Yeah, oh boy. Okay. Good. Oh boy. Always something, huh, guys? Yeah, I got stuff to clean that up. So. Let me clean up my tools here a little bit and we'll see if she'll fire up. The bowl gasket or the bowl nut. So pinch that off.
Ew, boy, it got smokier than hell in here, didn't it?
She's a smoker, but she does run. That's more than what she did before. Get some air circulating in here. So, with that being said, I should peel that off. She's leaking out the bubble gasket. She was tight enough. So I'll get online and see if I can't see what happens. Well, as always, guys, it's kind of a small victory. Got to run better than it was, but looks like I'm going to have to invest into a carb kit, and we will see about what we can do about getting her running a little better. All right, guys. Well, thanks for stopping by. And let's go check on Bruno and see what he's up to. And, well, we can see what he's been up to. Been sitting in your chair. All right, guys. Well, thanks for stopping by. I'm going to just call this a small victory. It runs on its own power. However, there's some leaking going on and stuff needs to be replaced, like the hoses, fuel line, I mean, and probably that bull nut gasket. As always, thanks for stopping by and keep on tinkering.